August 2nd marked the 88th anniversary of the birth of the literary voice of the civil rights movement, James Baldwin. James Baldwin was born here in Harlem. At age 10, he was beaten by police officers, and on his 14th birthday, was ordained by Pentecostal preacher. His first novel, Go Tell It on the Mountain, is considered one of the greatest works of the 20th century. He was part of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee and a close friend of Medgar Evers, Martin Luther King Jr., and Malcolm X. James Baldwin participated in the March on Washington and the March from Selma to Montgomery. He had become so much a spokesman for the civil rights, movement, that for its May 17th, 1963 issue, the movement in Birmingham, Time magazine put him on the cover. As we prepare to occupy our corners to address the violence in our community and the deaths of the innocent children as mere bystanders, James Baldwin's words and the evidence of things not seen still ring true today. When a city lives so long in the shadow of the terrifying violence, the crime grows greater than the deaths, the victims more numerous than the dead. Children have no defenses. A child believes everything. This is how he sorts out reality. When a child retreats and can no longer be reached, it is not that he has ceased to believe. It is that we who are all he has have failed him. Human life, and especially a child's life, is our most important gift, our only responsibility, and is more sacred than any other, than any temple or any doctrine anywhere. No justice.
No peace.